Okay, first and foremost, I want to give all honors and praises and glory beloved to my Lord and Savior, whose name is Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, Bahasham, Wahavakar Kodash. The name of the Heavenly Father is Yahawah, and his son's name is Yahawashi. Okay. And honors to the elder apostles of Great Millstone that taught me this truth. And those of you that are in the Holy Spirit, and to the hopeful elect across the globe, and to the very few brothers and sisters that are listening and also learning in the hopes of being saved within these last days. And I want to say to Wadi Yahawah, to Wadi Yahawah by Shem Yahawashi, to Wadi Yahawah, to Wadi Yahawah by Shem Yahawashi, for allowing me, for giving me the strength to get out here and to teach this word. So we're going to start off on Peter's. It's what you're going to find out when you're really teaching, when you're really walking, when you're really living in the ways of Yahawashi, in the ways that a true prophet should live, should walk. You're going to be hated. You're not going to be loved by the majority of the world. So one of the major things that need to be asked, that you need to examine is, well, if the world is loving you, then something's wrong. Because when Yahawashi was on the scene, he was hated. He received a lot of hate, especially from the majority of his own people. So this is what a lot of men are not really teaching you that, right? We're going to go to 1 Peter, spare me just a minute. We're going to go to 1 Peter. There's a lot of witches, warlocks in this truth. 1 Peter, right? This is 1 Peter 2. We can start at 2. Wherefore, laying aside all malice. So to lay aside, that means to put aside, to put away. You come to the truth, okay? You're supposed to put away malice. And what's malice? Malice means the intent to inflict injury or some type of hurt, whether it's by words, whether it's by physical. That's what malice is. So you've got a lot of individuals that have a malicious soul. And you know what the scripture says in Wisdom of Solomon 2? Wisdom will not dwell in a malicious soul, okay? Nor a body that is subject to sin. So you got to put that off when you come to the truth. You can't be malicious, especially towards those that are doing the work of Yahawah Shem Yahawashi, right? Because you've seen it. There's examples that of individuals that have done that. Where are they now? They're in a worse state than before, right? So lay aside all malice, right? And all guile is deceit. And Yahawashi said to Nathanael, blessed is him, a man who I find, bear me just a minute, a man with no guile. So Nathanael, he had no guile within his spirit. He was perfect in the eyes of Yahawashi. And it's the same thing today. You have an elect men that are upon the earth, they're perfect in the sight of Yahawashi, even though they've sinned. Right? Then you have men, they're wicked in the sight of Yahawashi. Right? And hypocrisies, because the Pharisees, the chief priests, they were practicing hypocrisy amongst each other. Just amongst each other. But it was a different rule for the rest. Right? That's why Yahawashi said, do as they say, but not as they do. Right? Because they were hypocrites. They were not leading by example. Right? And envies. You got men with an envious spirit from this truth. See, all the spirits of the world, somehow, some way, they've managed to creep up in the truth. These are all the spirits of the world. Envy. And you know what envy leads to? Hate. You know what hate leads to? Murder. Right? Which makes you a murderer. Just like Cain. Right? And evil speakings. Alright? As newborn babes. So when we come to this truth, we're newborn babes. You're in this 3 years newborn babe, 5 years, 6 years newborn babes. But some babes grow quicker than others. Okay? And that's just the way it is. That's just the way Yahawashi set it up. That some grow faster than others. And if you find yourself not growing, well, you need to pray. You need to go into deep, deep, deep prayer. And maybe you need to fast. Right? Desire the sincere milk of the word, that you may grow thereby. So you desire the sincere milk, that's how you grow. That's how you know someone's sincere. Because they're dealing with the milk. And guess what? They're growing through that milk. Some man, he wants to go into spiritual powers. But a man wants spiritual powers, but he doesn't have his own spirit in restraint. You don't even know how to conduct yourself amongst the world, but you want spiritual powers. So there's steps in everything. There's steps. Because the Lord Yahawashi ain't gonna hurt. You want spiritual powers, but you're malicious. You want spiritual powers, but you're deceitful. You're not gonna be given spiritual powers. Okay? The only thing you're going to be given is a big fat missile for your head. And destruction. Lest you repent. You got to come in this the right way. Right? That's why a lot of individuals, some, they hide behind the camera. Or they just stay in a little barrier of their confines. Because they're not bold for Yahawashi. Right? You gotta be able to take that next step, okay, in serving Yahawashi. If so, that you have tasted that the Lord Yahawashi, and that word for tasted goes into experience, right? So the main thing in this truth is to gain experience, because you could be looking at another man's what he's going through. But you ain't going for it yourself, so your words don't really have any power, as much power, because you ain't been through that situation, right? Those that are going through particular experiences, they're growing, okay? They're showing forth what? Character, right? Verse 4, to whom coming? As unto a living stone, disallowed indeed of men. So we gotta be living stones. Living means alive, right? Living stones, disallowed of men. That reminds me of who Yahawashi. Yahawashi Yahawashi is disallowed of men. Right? Because even his own nation didn't receive him. Even within our own nation, our own people didn't receive us. That's why we go into Esau. We know, yeah, Esau's the wicked, but what men are not really showing you is Yahawashi was disallowed indeed of men. So when it was saying disallowed of men, was he speaking about the Romans? I wasn't speaking about the Romans. Our own nation, those calling themselves Israelites. So the wickedness, what Yahawashi, what Paul, what John, most of the apostles, what they were teaching you, the main thing was of false prophets, false teachers, deceivers, witches, warlocks, our own nation. That's what they were teaching you about. Esau is just a product of us going off. That's all Esau is. That's all Esau is, the product of us going off. The whipping stick when we go off. But the main problem was our nation. That's always been the problem. So the sooner you find it out, the sooner you look around and be like, now I see the truth in a whole different way. Your eyes are open. Men don't want your eyes to be open. And if your eyes were open, I tell you this, just being real. And I always say there's nothing wrong with camps, but a lot of men, they wouldn't be in camps. If your eyes were truly open, you probably would be teaching by yourself. Because the wickedness is in these camps. A lot of these camps are corrupt. A lot of these camps are deceitful, right? A lot of the killers of the prophets are in these camps, right? So this is what I'm trying to show you, right? I'm not just making this up. But if you don't see it now, you're going to see it eventually, right? And it says, but chosen of the Most High. So we can also equate this with ourselves, disallowed indeed of men, but chosen of the Most High. So that's favor. That's what we're looking for. Favor from Yahawashi. Because in this time right now, men are always going to find fault. So this is why we're pushing this truth. So we can be seen as favorable to Yahawashi, not to men, because men change. Okay, men get demons upon them. Men can love you one day and hate you the next, right? That's why the favor we seek is through Yahawashi, right? Not worldly validation, vainglory and all that rubbish. That don't matter, because this world's going to perish and the lust thereof, right? All this worldly validation. Yahawashi never taught you to be highly exalted in this world, to be spoken good of in this world. He never taught you that. So the men that are in that lot, they've already received their consolation. Right? They've already received their reward. Built up a spiritual house. Ye are also lively still. So, yeah, you know, sometimes we're a bit mellow in the spirit, but we're still somewhat lively. Lively stones. In other words, you're apt to teach. That's what it means, lively stones. Right? Because the scriptures talk about precious stones. We are them precious stones. And we're lively. You're supposed to be lively, enthusiastic about this truth, about teaching. Because if you're not, then you're just wasting your time. Built up a spiritual house. So this is a spiritual house. This is the house of the word. Built up. So the house, the tabernacle, is being built. The house of David. And there's only one house of David. And you got the house of Saul. And you were going to know the house of David for the passion, for the fervency they have for this truth. The house of David weren't going to be slothful. The house of David, they were not going to have an evil eye towards their brother. The house of Sal, on the other hand, that would be the house of Sal. Right? The house of David, we're going to be obedient. Right? The house of David, we're going to be diligent. Right? And to offer up spiritual sacrifices. So we're offering up these spiritual sacrifices. Right now what we're doing, this is a sacrifice unto Yahawashi, right? And it's acceptable, right? To the Most High by Yahawashi, Mashiach. Wherefore it is also contained in the scripture, behold, I lay in Zion a chief cornerstone, and that cornerstone is speaking about Yahawashi. What's a cornerstone? A cornerstone is what you build around, and that you build on top of. That's the cornerstone. So what's the foundation of our faith? It's Yahawashi, right? That we're building upon. See, we're not building upon other men. We're building upon Yahawashi, right? Men have made this about themselves. That's where you're not seeing things straight, right? It's always been about Yahawashi. It's always been about His will, right? Not your will. Not the camp's will. Yahawashi's will. To hell with what you think. I'm going to speak what the scriptures tell me to say, right? Elect precious, and he that believeth on him shall not be confounded. So that's why it's so important to believe in Yahawashi. If you believe in Yahawashi, you're not going to be confounded. Okay, you're not going to be overtaken by this world. Okay, and you're going to be what? Stable. Those that are confounded are those that have not put their trust in Yahawashi. It all begins with faith. That's what it all begins with. And only Yahawashi can give you that. We can teach you faith, but myself personally, I can't give you faith. But we can teach you that. And it's for you to be built up. And men that don't have faith, they're going to be looking at others that have that faith, seeking to slew them. So this is how it works. Got men that will see 50 odd chariots, but they still don't have any faith. That's because it wasn't given to you. Faith is a gift, right? That's that same unfaithful generation that was murmuring in the time of Moses, complaining about the garlic, the leeks, returning back to Egypt. It's that same generation. Unto you, Rem. Unto you, therefore, which believe, he is precious. This is what it's about. You have to believe in Yahawashi. Point blank, period. Right? You have to. You want to be justified, but you have to believe in Yahawashi. Alright? The condemnation is to them that don't believe in Yahawashi. Right? That's who the condemnation is to. The condemnation is to those that are doing this work deceitfully. But unto them which be disobedient, and a lot of our people, they're disobedient to what Yahawashi says. Yahawashi says, go out into the highways and byways, you go out into the forest, disobedient. Yahawashi says, be on fire for the truth. Don't be lukewarm, you be lukewarm, disobedient. Right? The stone which the builders disallowed, that stone was Yahawashi. And the builders are what? The tribes of our own people. The builders were also the first of the chief priests. They rejected Yahawashi. Yeah, the elders and the Pharisees, they rejected Yahawashi. And you got the same thing going on again today. Men want you to worship them. Get the fuck out of here. I'm going to worship Yahawashi. Right? You're not with their camp. You're not with their group. They just write you off. No, that's not true. Yahawashi has an elect that he's dealing with. Whether they're in camps or not. It's ain't about camps. It's about, is Yahawashi dealing with you? Personally. What? That's what Yahawashi's looking at. Yahawashi looks at things within the camps individually. He's looking at the individuals within the camps. Seeing who's sincere and who's not. The same is made the head of the corner, which is Yahawashi. And he's the head of the church. And a stone of stumbling and a rock of offense. So when we bring out this word, it's like you're just teaching the word. And people, they get offended. They hate you because you're just teaching the word. But they personalize it. They personalize that hate. But in Israeli, it's Yahawashi, because a man ain't gonna tell you, now it's the word. He's gonna personalize it. Rarely see how shy they hate. Right? A stone of stumbling and a rock of offense. See how shy? He's that rock of offense. Right? Why do you think they wanted to grab him up? Because he was offending people. He was saying things that people did not like. Right? He was ruffling a lot of feathers. Okay? He was making people, angry. Right? That's the type of life of a prophet. So therefore you become hated because you're not a part of this world. So those that are a part of this world, you're going to be hated by them. Because they have not departed from the world. Okay? And now you are that light, you're that little bit of light in this wicked dark world. Right? So that makes people feel a particular way. Right? Because when you have light, it draws all types. You have light, you can still draw evil to you. Evil can still be drawn to you. And goodness, more so goodness, but the evil, they hate the light, right? And a rock of offense, so many other people are offended at Yahawashi. That's why they gave him over to the Romans. And that was their own people. And this is prophecy. Because the same thing again is happening again today. So it's prophecy, right? Even to them which stumble at the words, right? And the scripture says, let their table become a snare and a stumbling block. Right? That was a prayer of David. But stumble at the words. You got men there offending that particular stuff, particular things that come out. And it makes them feel a particular way. But I thought you were about the laws. How are you about the laws, but you're offended when the laws come out about particular things? Because you are a hypocrite. That's why. But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, which is referring to the Israelites. Right? A chosen priesthood. The prophets, they're also priests as well. A holy nation. Alright? So holy is what's separate. What's separate from these other nations. That's what it means to be holy. peculiar people. Peculiar means strange. Okay, we're seeing the strange of these other nations. That's what it means to be peculiar. Different. A peculiar people. But you should show forth the praise of him that have called you out of darkness and his marvelous lights. Now we've been called out of darkness. What's that darkness? The world. That's what we've been called out of. Into this marvelous light. And it is marvelous. You know? But now you're in the light. You want to stay in the light. A lot of men, they have this light, but they don't stay in the light because they're too preoccupied with the world. They go back into the world. And then they're what? Shrouded in darkness. Right? Bear me just a minute. One of my favorite scriptures, because it speaks volumes, right? Where your treasure is, there will your heart be so also. And your heart is your mind. So your mind is gonna what? Be focused on the things that you put most time into, right? Your mind's going to be focused on the things you put the most time into. Right? The light of the body is the eye, which is referred to your mind. And you can also equate this with the physical eye. So that's that light. Right? Which is what? From your mind. And your mind is what? Your soul. Right? All right. Morning. So that's what your light is, your mind, your essence. That's what the light is, right? If the whole eye be single, so that's why it's so important to stay focused. So when you're single, you're concentrating on one thing. And one thing only, that's salvation. That's the coming of the return of Yahawashi, Yahawashi. Because your eyes are single. It's not focused on all this other rubbish out here. Okay? Things that don't even matter. That's when your eye ain't single. Right? The whole body shall be full of light, so you're going to have that radiance about you. You're going to have that glow about you. Okay? Because your mind is preoccupied on wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. On Yahawashi, it actually shows when someone is focused about this truth. That shows. You can't fake this. Okay? But if the eye be evil, evil's what? Wicked, right? So if the eye be evil, which is what? Wicked, thy whole body shall be full of darkness. That means your whole mind is going to be full of darkness. And it's going to show in your countenance as well. And I'm not talking about a dark camera, the camera's dark. I'm not talking about that. Your whole mind is going to be full of darkness. It says if your mind be evil, the whole body shall be full of darkness. That's why you can't let this world overtake you. You've got to be in this day in, day out. You miss a day and you make up for that day. If you don't, because what? Men are being overcome by what? Deceitful, evil spirits on a large scale, on a very large scale. That's why I can't watch everybody's video right now. There was a point in time in this truth where you may watch everybody's video in great. You can't do that now because men have got evil, wicked spirits on them, right? And they want you to be in that same spirit, right? See, that takes discernment. That rarely takes discernment, right? You got to identify in these last days, well, who is the Holy Spirit dealing with? And if you're identifying that, that's who you listen to. That's who you watch. Because if you're listening to a bunch of evil, deceitful men, you're going to be the same way. You're going to be the same way. You're just going to be like them. And the scripture says, follow not a multitude to do wicked. So you're not supposed to follow a multitude of people just because they're doing evil. Right? Bear me just a minute. You're not supposed to follow them. Right? Follow Yahawashi and the men that have the Holy Spirit upon them. That's who you follow. Right? You're following a man that has hatred for his brother. That means you're following a murderer. And that means you're going to be the same way. You're following a man that can't take rebuke, that's deceitful. That means you're going to be the same way. Right? And this is what's happened over time. And men can't even see it. Right? If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness, how great is that darkness? So, that light that you had is the wisdom. So, if that turns into darkness, that means you've been what? Overtaken. You can't let this place overtake you. Have to stay in the spirit to the best of your ability. And you know you're not going to be in the spirit all the time. But you have to strive to be in the spirit to the best of your ability. Right? Let's go to verse 24. No man can serve two masters. You can't serve the world and serve the truth. Oh, you know. Let me just stick one foot out. One foot out into the world. One foot out into the truth. Just in case it doesn't go down, you know? Just in case this place don't go down, just in case it ain't true, that means you don't have faith. That means you don't have faith, right? That means you're not certain. I'm certain this kingdom's gonna go down. The wicked are going to go down. I'm certain of that. Right? I'm certain my enemies are going to be destroyed. Right? I'm certain Yahawashi is the Son of the Most High. And his words are true. So you've got to continue maintain that belief. Right? No man can serve two masters. Because you got men, they have that spirit, well, oh, I've got to work. Bro, but you've got to hustle, but you've got to do things. My scripture says, no man can serve two masters. That's Yahawashi speaking. Right? You really want to serve the world. You really want to do the things of the world. But you want to merge that with the truth. You can't mix the both. You can't mix the world with the truth. And this is what men have done. So they're not really walking in the ways of Yahawashi. They're walking in the ways of the world. They're trying to introduce the world into the truth, which it doesn't work. There's only one way, right? For either he will hate the one and love the other. So you're going to be in conflict in your mind. You're either going to love this word, the truth, Yahawashi, or you're going to be more given unto this world. Which that's what you call a mental illness. That's what you call a plague of the mind. Someone that can't make up whether they want to be in the truth or go back into the world or serve their women. Right? And that's why men are highly emotional, because they're under their women too long. Alright? Or else you would hold to the one and despise the other. That's how it's going to be. Because you never made that stance from the beginning. You're supposed to have a stance. Well, is it the world or is it the truth? It's supposed to be the truth all the time. Right? You're supposed to put the truth before everything. Right? Hold to the one and despise the other. So I was letting you know, you were going to push one away because one was more profitable to you, one you liked the most. Got individuals, they love the world more than they love the truth, therefore they're of the world. You cannot serve the Most High and Mammon. So you cannot serve Yahawashi and really the God of this world, which is also money. A lot of people, they all have money, money, money. That's another thing you got to watch out for. Someone can't do the work, and his excuse is always, oh, I've got to make more money. I've got to make more money. You better get away from that. You better get away from an individual like that. I've got to make more money. Wherever the money is, he's there. So the signs are already there of Judas goats, men that will quickly sell you out for a quick buck. Because there's nothing for Esau to go to a demonic-ass nigger that's all about money and say, you know, would you do this? Would you slander him? Would you do that? You know, it's nothing for men to do that at all. That's why you got to keep your eyes open. You got to be circumspect in these last days. Right? So now we're going to jump to 1 Corinthians, all right? And we know you were going to get men that fall out. And it happens also during the Passover. Always during the Passover, before the Passover and after the Passover, you always have individuals that fall out, right? And they're no longer seen. They no longer do the work, right? So again, every man's work being proven, who really believes and who don't, right? You're not going to be able to fake this truth. You're not going to be able to hide behind the camp, right? You're not going to be able to do that for any longer. Go to 1 Corinthians 3, and there's a lot of meat right here, right? There's a lot of meat. Let's go to 3. I, brethren, cannot speak unto you as unto spiritual. Why? Because you're yet still carnal, right? And men, they associate, well, you know, you've been in the truth for 5-6 years, you can't know. I believe I'm highly spiritual. I can see a lot what others don't see because I've dedicated my life to this truth, right? So a lot of our people, they're not spiritual, right? They're carnal because they've dedicated their lives to the world. So you become carnal. You can be in this truth 10 years, but you're still carnal. You still have no eyesight, right? But as unto carnal, even as unto babes, right? Even unto babes. So when our people first wake up to truth, when you're teaching certain people, you have to speak to them in a particular manner, right? I just saw an English Bull Terrier. Any of you know about English Bull Terrier? They're lovely dogs. They're really, 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 really loyal dogs. Really loyal. Okay, bear me just a minute. And that's what Yahawashi's looking for. Loyalty. You're loyal to him. Not this man, because men were trying to say that. Oh, he ain't loyal. Well, what if this man's wicked and deceitful? No, you're loyal to Yahawashi, you're loyal to his cause. Right? I have fed you with milk and with meat. For hereto you were not able to bear it. Certain brothers in the truth, you may be feeding them. Okay. Okay, with milk and not with meat. Because they can't handle it. Certain things in the scriptures men can't handle, it's too much. And they end up bugging out. Right? Or getting offended.